quick tutorial on making a 5-number summary and a box plot on a TI. See, I'm doing a TI-83 plus, but something similar. I decided to illustrate this with some data. So here's some data I just kind of made up that I think will illustrate all the key points of these two things. The first thing you want to do is put this data into a list. I'm not going to spend any time on that. I have a separate video telling you how to put data into lists, but I've already gone ahead and done that to save some time. As you can see here, my first list contains all those data points. If you scroll down, you can see the rest of them. Anyways, I got my data in here. So maybe the first thing I'll do is calculate my 5-number summary. A 5-number summary is 5 different numbers that kind of describes a lot of the data. What those 5 numbers are the minimum value, the first quartile, the median, the third quartile, and the maximum. And it turns out these 5 things your calculator will give you all under one variable statistics. So there's a separate video on one variable statistics, but I'll do it again here because that topic comes up again. If you hit the stat button and then go over to calc, so stat and then the right cursor, so I guess I should write this in here. I'm gonna hit stat. So maybe first enter data and then stat, and then go over to the calc menu. And then the first thing listed says one variable statistics. And so if you go into that menu, or into the, using that function, what it'll pull up, it'll say one variable statistics. And then you want to tell it what list your data's in. So maybe I'll say one variable statistics L1, because I put my data in L1. If you put your data in a different list, you'll want to list that list here to list the list. You'll note there's a little L1 above this one key in orange. So I'll hit the orange key, and then 1, and L1 will pop up. Turns out your calculator defaults to L1. If you just put one variable stats in, it'll assume your data is in L1. So that was more than I had to do, but I wanted to illustrate it in case you put your data into a different list. Anyways, hit enter, and a bunch of stuff will come out, things that maybe you've seen before. But if you scroll down, it gives you 5 values. It tells us that our minimum was equal to 1. It's good, that was our minimum value. Our, maybe I should go in order. The first quartile is equal to 4. The median is equal to 7.5. The third quartile is equal to 15. And the maximum is equal to 35. All of these can, or I guess these 3 can be calculated by hand also. I'll have a separate video showing you how to do that, but the purpose of this is just to use your calculator. So there's how you get those values out of a calculator. So this right here is your 5-number summary, which is kind of nice. We can now move on to our box plot. It'll turn out when you're making your box plot, you'll kind of use some of this stuff. So when you're making your box plot, well, let's see, box plot. First thing is enter your data, but we already have our data in there, but I'll list it anyways in case you're just doing that. Enter data. And the second thing you want to do is go under the stat plot menu. So let's say stat plot, which you can get to by hitting second and then y equals. It's up here. So I hit second and then y equals. And then the third thing we want to do is go into one of these. So I'll just go into the first one here, turn it on. Maybe, I don't know, program, box plot. The way you do that is first you have to turn it on, select the one that kind of looks like a box plot is this fourth one. I know the fifth one looks like a box plot too. The fifth one is actually just a visual representation of the 5-number summary. So we won't be using that, we'll be using the fourth one here. Select fourth type, and then tell it where your data is. specify list. Let's be a little bit more technical. So we'll specify our list. I put my values in L1, so it's already defaulted there, which is nice. But if you put it in somewhere else, you can hit second and then that list, and it'll pop up. Leave frequency alone, and the mark, if you want to change what outliers will look like, you can change that here, but you don't have to. And then 4 is zoom/adjust window. You can try either zoom stat or zoom fit. That one doesn't work quite as good. These are kind of ways for your calculator to guess how big you want the window to be. So zoom stat is saying, if you're doing statistical stuff, how big should the window be? So we can try that here. We'll hit this zoom button, and then we'll go down to zoom stat, which is way down here. Go away. Number 9 on my list. So I hit enter, and it gives me a little picture here, which is nice, which you'll be able to see when this Gmail thing goes away in a second. Maybe there's a way for me to make that go away. I don't know how. So good. So we got a little picture we can view. Let's say try zoom stat, zoom fit, maybe not quite as good. And then finally, you can trace to see features. And what I mean by trace, you hit this trace key right here, and it'll tell you things like our median is equal to 7.5. Nice. It'll tell us that our first quartile is equal to 4. So it kind of confirms a lot of these things off of our box plot. Our minimum value is equal to 1. Doesn't really look like a check, but that's what I was going for. And then coming over to the other side, we got our third quartile is 15. And what you'll see here is that it'll just say x equals 25. This ends up being our upper fence, or no, that's not true. This is our largest observation that is not considered an outlier. So this is our largest observation that is not above the upper fence or below the lower fence. I don't know how to say that. This is our largest observation that is not above the upper fence, is this x equals 25. And if you go out one more to the right, we see that our max value here is 35. So what this is saying is I have my box plot that looks something like this-ish. And I got this value out here. And this one is my outlier at 35. And then I had 25 here. This is my third quartile, Q3, which was 15. This is my median, which was 7.5. My first quartile, which was 4. And my minimum, which was 1. 35 was the max. It's also an outlier. The reason 35 was an outlier, you can figure that out by finding your fences. So maybe I'll finish up by doing that, and then we'll end this video. Your lower fence, so how calculator determined this outlier. We got the lower fence is always equal to Q1 minus 1.5 times IQR, and the upper fence is equal to Q3 plus 1.5 times the interquartile range IQR. And just because I'm short on room up here, I can say the interquartile range is always Q3 minus Q1. So in this case, it's 15 minus 4. Which is 11. So what that gives me is a way of determining my upper and lower fences are kind of my bounds to determine what are outliers. So Q1 was equal to 4, Q3 was equal to 15, and then from the 4 I want to subtract 1.5 of these 11s, and from the 15 I want to add, or to the 15 I want to add 1.5 of these 11s. So 1.5 11s is what, 16.5? I'm gonna go ahead and use a calculator here. 4 minus 16.5 is negative 12.5. And then 16 and a half plus 15 is 31 and a half. So these are bounds, B-O-U-N-D-S, for outliers. So what your calculator does is it says, all right, any data point between negative 12 and a half and 31 and a half is fine. That one works. But anything that's not in between these two values, I'm going to call an outlier. So it looked at my data set and it decided 35 is not between these two values, so it's an outlier. But everything else is between those two values. So it takes this point, this 35, and kind of puts it separate out here as the 35. And then it does something kind of like a five-number summary, but not quite, because this isn't the maximum, it's the maximum non-outlier. So maybe I'll even label this. Note, this is my maximum non-outlier. So it's possible to have several outliers, maybe even on both sides. That'll work fine. The one thing I want to point out is these fences, these bounds right here, don't appear in your picture. That's a mistake everyone makes as they try to graph them. You don't do that. You just look at these to figure out what's an outlier. But really, that's a lot of interpretation of this. I guess the point of this video is just to show you how to make one on a TI. So we were done with that by the time we were done with the red. This is getting a little too long, so I should probably wrap this thing up. So that's the end of this video.